Here's your correspondent from the Nordics again. I got something new for you. I got a new Swedish series which is coming in. Well, it's not really known yet, but it is something exciting that we're going to talk about here. Guys, welcome. Also, I found something, I heard something about a new Swedish series, and it's called Whiskey on the Rocks. So what do you think it's about?
Drinking again? Like the last movie with Mads Mikkelsen?
I was thinking of Whiskey in the Jarro, that cover from Metallica. But
oh, yeah, it could be something like that, but it isn't, because this is about, apparently, and I never heard of it, but it's about a real-life diplomatic incident that almost led to a war between Sweden and the Soviet Union in the 1980s. This is the story. I will dig in a bit more about it in this video, and also what this series is going to be about, who will be cast in it, who's the writer. But before we get into that, for the people watching, we follow a lot of Nordic stuff, especially me living in Sweden. I follow the Nordic series and movies on this channel. So if you want to stay updated on those and also on this series, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
Yes.
No, yeah. So the background behind this story, I never heard of it, but that's what I like about this channel, that I get also to know a bit more about the Swedish history, so to say. So it's not only movies, but also Swedish history. So apparently in the 1980s, it was a Soviet Navy whiskey class submarine. I never heard of it. Koen, you're a bit more into the war stuff.
I know the story that you want to say, because I remember that there was an incident with continue. Yeah.
Yeah, so
no, I'm just thinking, I'm trying to recalculate the story in my mind. I remember that there was a whiskey.
I will tell you about it.
Yeah, exactly.
That's right. So it was a Soviet Navy whiskey class submarine that ran aground on rocks deep inside Swedish territorial waters. It was in the middle of a Swedish naval exercise. And this
during the Cold War?
Apparently, yeah. So this led apparently to a Cold War standoff between Sweden and the Soviet Union that took 11 days of high stakes negotiation. So that's the background behind this, and they are now making a series about this incident by the Swedish production company Dramacorp.
It's going to be dramatic, no?
Well, that's the fun thing, because they actually said that they were first thinking about making a straight political thriller, but in the end, there's apparently so much absurdity about this whole incident situation that they are turning it now into a dramedy.
Wow, dramedy. And
I always love dramedies. Give it a bit of a comedic touch. So that's interesting. And what is very interesting about this is that the writer of this series, and who is someone I think that can execute a dramedy very well, because the writer of this series is Jonas Jonasson. He's now, over the last decade, he became one of the most best-selling authors of Sweden. He has worldwide sold 16 million books across 46 countries. So he's really, and there's one story that you might know, because it's his most famous one, and that's the story that's called The 100-Year-Old Man Who Climbed Out of the Window and Disappeared.
That's a really famous story, also being translated in Dutch. It was a bestseller
It was a bestseller. I also read it. I have it here on my bookshelf. It's a great story. And it was also turned into a movie, actually, and which was nominated for the Oscars, and it became the biggest Swedish blockbuster.
Is there a trailer to see, Buzz, about this movie?
No trailer yet. This is the first news. Yeah, this is the first news that comes out about this series. First time they come out with a press release about it. We did get some quotes from the writer, Jonas Jonasson, and the head of the production studio. So Jonas Jonasson said, "I have always said that reality supersedes fiction, though I'm pretty skilled at coming up with stuff nonetheless. There was no way that I would decline the offer to take on the bizarre and true story about a Soviet nuclear submarine gone off course." So that's the quote that he had about it. And then the head of the production studio, Patrick Nabu, I don't know how to pronounce exactly, said, "Jonas has such a unique approach and angle on infamous historical events and characters. We couldn't dream of a better voice to retell a story that is Scandinavia's very own version of the Cuban Missile Crisis." So,
nice.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking about. Like, this is more like the same crisis in Cuba. So he was already making this comparison.
Exactly, but apparently there's quite a lot of, because that's what the head of the studio talked when they started digging into this story. There was more and more absurdities about it, why they decided to make add a bit more comedy to it. Because first, when I read about this news and Jonas Jonasson being the writer of the script, it didn't really seem to fit for me because he has a bit of a, well, at least I only read one of his books. That's the 100-year-old man book. And it's very comedic, a bit light in its style. So I felt like, how will this fit with this story? But now that I heard that it's going to be a dramedy, it makes a bit more sense.
The title is nice, of course, Whiskey on the Rocks.
yeah, that already suggests
it's kind of on the rocks.
comedic approach.
Yeah.
Which I like also more because I would not really getting warm of a really heavy, dark drama, Cold War series, I would say. I think you're also not bosses, I know you. I think when they put a little bit of Scandinavian humor into it and what they are... I don't know if they're known for it, but they're probably good at it. They are, that's more promising for me.
Yeah, I agree with you. I also got more excited. I got very excited when I heard that this guy was involved because I love his book, The 100-Year-Old Man. If you haven't read it or haven't seen a movie, go read it or watch it. It's about this, 100-year-old man who climbs out of the window and he starts having a whole adventure. And he's involved with all kinds of historical events. It reminded me somehow also a bit of Forrest Gump, that of course in Forrest Gump, he's also gets mixed up in all these historic events.
Exactly.
And it's also for this man who retells the story. So that got me enthusiastic.
Cool. All right. Well, looking forward. Do you know when it's going to be released?
There's very little known for the rest of it. This is the first press release. They start working on it now. So I would assume we don't have to expect anything in 2021 about this. At earliest, I would think 2022.
Wow.
But really I will. Yes, exactly. But it gives us the time to keep a close eye on it and to bring some news about it once there is news about it. And of course, when there is a trailer, we will also react to that. So for the people watching, if you want to stay updated on all that, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Give us a little thumbs up if you like our little report over here. And then we see you at the next Nordic thing we talk about on this channel.
Nice.
Hey, bye.